To date, only 11% of working Ugandans have social security, according to the National Social Security Fund. But the NSSF has an ambitious target of widening the social security net to 50% of working Ugandans by 2035, and enforcing compliance is one of the strategies the fund is fronting to achieve this target. Patrick Ayota, the NSSF Managing Director, said only 20,000 of the 36,000 employers are making timely and full remittances of their employees' contributions to the fund.
Complete anonymity to the whistleblower. In other words, the whistleblower's identity, there's an option the whistleblower picks. The whistleblower's identity is not revealed to either the fund or the employer, so the whistleblower is protected. Automatic tracking of reported cases. Once a whistleblower goes and makes a report, they can actually track and see how far the case has gone and what resolutions have been made in that case.
He adds that only 107 cases of non-compliance are reported to the fund monthly, attributing this to employee fear of witch hunt by their employers.
The most interesting thing when we declared interest on September,
27. Yeah.
The minister declared the interest, I think, right close to midday. The first interest credit went out like 10 minutes after, and I was sitting next to a guy. He gets his credit, and his neighbor said, "Where's mine?" He's asking, "Where's mine?" So the point of it is, once you engage members and they are part of your process, they own it. And what you're going to find out is they help compliance. That's really what we want to engage. The rest of the 2.2 million Ugandans, or 800,000 Ugandans who are active, to become very, very vigilant on what's happened to their accounts. And because it's their money, people get involved with that. So we think working together will help us.
At least 8.9 billion in employee contributions has been recovered by the fund from non-compliant through litigation over the last 2 years. Story by Ben Ojambo for the news.